WWE Tribute to the Troops, Christmas Eve at 9, only on USA.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen, live here on Monday Night Raw, a handicap match.
Can I say that this may be the strangest beginning of a Raw that I've ever witnessed? And last week was our 15th anniversary of Raw.
It may be the most unique half hour of Monday Night Raw that I personally have ever experienced. The Raw General Manager, William Regal, his assistant, Jonathan Coachman, will have a two-on-one handicap match here and now against Triple H. Obviously, none are dressed to compete.
And this is an offspring of the
meltdown.
I think Mr. McMahon's had a nervous breakdown.
Man out here earlier talking about how his feelings were hurt. He had been beaten, knocked out, humiliated last week on our 15th anniversary broadcast.
I think he was crying.
He had a broken heart, as he said. Well, you know, and then slumping down the corner is very un-Mr. McMahon-like, I assure you. So now we are here with that information and a handicap match between Triple H, William Regal, and the coach. And Triple H just involved 24 hours ago in that outstanding matchup with Jeff Hardy.
Well, one shot from Triple H and the coach is down, possibly for the count, but William Regal.
Look out.
Hang on easy now.
Bouncing what a right hand. And Coach trying to sneak up on Triple H to no avail. Yeah, but Regal does.
There's nothing subtle about kind of the coach, but Regal's got this now.
Regal's got a deadly left hand, to say the least. And the general manager of Raw now. Oh, my God. Good Lord.
A
brutal kick.
Get him, you pillock.
A brutal kick by William Regal, and there's a cover by Coachman. How humiliating! Started to say how humiliating it would be to the game to get pinned by John the Coachman.
Well, I'm going to tell you, anybody could get pinned for that catch.
Triple H's head smashing into the steel ring post after being kicked violently, aggressively by William Regal.
You say, how did Triple H kick out after having his head bashed like that?
And the hard knee right to the face by the battler from Blackpool, England, the general manager of Raw, again connecting with those left hands.
Well, of course, you said William Regal or Triple H, certainly not out here dressed to compete, but William Regal is quite the competitor.
And down goes Coachman. And down goes the general manager as Triple H fighting his way back into this impromptu, bizarrely orchestrated handicap matchup.
Just reversal here.
Oh, yeah. How about a face buster instead? And Jonathan Coachman finds himself at the mercy of Triple H, the cerebral assassin.
But Jonathan Coachman had no idea this would happen. Oh, wait a minute.
Regal doing it.
Look at that.
Hey, what the? Brass knuckles are not legal enough in a handicap match.
Watch it. He's got the.
Whoa. Oh. Spinebuster by the game. Regal's brass knucks not coming into play on that exchange. But Jonathan Coachman reaching for the brass knuckles. And has him on his right hand. Busted. Jonathan Coachman.
Yeah. I explained that those weren't yours.
And that Coachman wasn't going to use them.
I didn't bring these.
Situation for Coachman, and now his pedigree will be tipped.
He's going to explain his way out of this.
The coach is not going to take his way out of a pedigree. And the game wins as handicap match. I'm sure that the chairman of the WWE is not pleased say the very, very least about the outcome of this match.
Oh, wait a minute. Mr. McMahon did say he hoped something bad happened to everyone here tonight. Something bad just happened to William Regal and Coach.
Well, William Regal, during the commercial break, obviously, was thinking ahead where to use the brass knucks, but,
well,
that was a knock.
Not kidding, that'll swell right up. And then the pedigree from Triple H, and Coach's night went from bad to worse.
Ironically, it was the Triple H's opponent, Jeff Hardy, who tried to, he really told Mr. McMahon how many people felt about the chairman. And then the man that had the courage to come down and confront Mr. McMahon was the game.
Well,